You're probably going to be using your financial calculator a lot in this class, so I kind of want to provide a short intro to one of the more popular choices and the one I recommended, the TI Business Analyst 2. Both a quick start guide and a complete user manual for the TI are available online, so I'm only going to cover a few settings and operational issues that are particularly relevant for this class. Looking at the calculator, when you first turn it on, the default setting is 2 decimal places. 4 is a better choice. You get more precision. To reset the format to 4, press second and format, the period at the bottom. The display will show decimal equals 2. Press 4 and enter, and you can see number of decimal places changes to 4. To get out of this, press second and quit. Decimal setting is set to 4 and it will stay that way until you change it, even when you turn the calculator on and off. There's 2 important characteristics about the TI that we need to keep in mind. Number 1, entered values stay until they're cleared or overlaid. The second thing is, interest rates are entered as whole numbers. In Excel and in formulas, interest rates are decimals. 5% is 0.05. In this and in most financial calculators, 5% is entered as a 5. With that said, the 2 specific functions that we'll be using a lot are the time value of money keys and the cash flow worksheet. So we're going to take a little quick look at both of those. The TVM keys are those 5 highlighted keys above the keypad, N, IY, PV, PMT, and FV. Now remember, what's been entered before is still stored unless it's cleared or overlaid. You can clear all 5 of those keys by hitting second and clear time value of money. Or, since you've got 5 keys and you're going to solve for one of them, just enter something in all the other 4, even if it's one of them is 0. When you're entering data in these keys, there's no need to press enter like we did when we were changing the decimals. Just the number and the key. 5N10IY. You'll know the value has been correctly entered because the number of decimal places will change to 4. We're going to explore the TVM keys individually in a separate tutorial, TVM keys, where we'll look at both the TI keys and the associated Excel functions. The other feature we'll be using a lot is a worksheet. TI's got several of them, and all of them work in a similar way. Think of a worksheet like a column in Excel. You enter a value and you move down to enter another one. You move back up to check what you've entered. So the important keys are the Enter key, the up arrow, and the down arrow. That's how you move around. To put a value in a worksheet cell, you key in the value and press enter, like we did to change the decimals. To move to the next cell, press the down arrow. The worksheet we're going to be using the most is the cash flow worksheet, the CF worksheet. A separate tutorial on it covers this in a lot more depth, but I want to introduce it a little bit now. Since the cash flow worksheet allows the entry of up to 25 cash flows, it's important to clear it before entering any data because there could be data left in there. To do that, press CF, second, and clear work, and it clears it out completely. Another worksheet that we'll be using is the iConvert worksheet. iConvert is used to convert nominal interest rates to effective rates or vice versa. You access it by pressing second and the 2 key, iConvert. This little worksheet only has 3 cells, nominal, effective, and compounding per year. So in this case, it's not too critical that you clear it out. You can, but you've got to enter 2 of them and solve for the 3rd one. Suppose a bank quotes you 5% compounded monthly and you want the effective rate. You would press second and iConvert and nominal will appear. Enter a 5, enter, go down twice, get to compounding per year. This is monthly. Compounding per year is 12. Enter that, go back up to effective, and press compute. Your effective rate is 5.1162. Now, brief as this is, it should get you started with the TI. And as I said, for more detailed information, there's a quick start guide and the user guide.